So the first question that I want to tackle is about who develops severe COVID, who is at risk for developing severe COVID and associated symptoms. In our community of patients with cancer, those who are at most risk are, number one, those with blood cancer, such as leukemias. Number two, those who have had treatments for those types of cancers that may include a stem cell transplant, also known as a bone marrow transplant. And the third population of patients who are at risk are those who've been on chronic immune suppression, such as being on steroids for a very long time. All of those categories of people are at higher risk of developing more severe COVID, and that can end up in hospitalization. So it's very important that if you or a loved one are in these categories, you're taking special precautions. The second question is about masking. So masking is still necessary, and that's the answer right out of the gate, but only in certain scenarios. So if you are vaccinated and you're in a community where there's very low transmission rate, or if you are aware fully of your surroundings and know that everyone is healthy, there may not be a need to mask. However, if you are at high risk, or if you are in a scenario where there's a lots of people around. So for example, if you're taking a flight and have to wait in a crowded airport gate area, you may not know if there's COVID in the waiting area. People can be sick and not quite realize it. And if you are at high risk of developing severe COVID, wearing a mask can protect you. Of course, if you are sick, wearing a mask can protect others, and that is equally, if not more important. Vaccines. Let's talk a little bit about vaccines. So it's very important to get your booster. We know that with the coronavirus and its variants that have spread through the community, the vaccine situation has changed as time has gone on. However, drug makers are staying on top of developing vaccines that target new variants. And for this reason, having a booster dose of the latest variety is very important for your health. This can help protect you against new strains of the COVID-19 virus. Having a booster can also help protect others, because if you stay healthy, you're at less risk of transmitting it to others. Sometimes COVID happens despite the vaccine. However, having the booster vaccines really can help keep severe COVID and hospitalization from happening. And the last question I'll tackle is about treatments for COVID. There are at least three antiviral treatments that are recommended for the treatment of COVID, not prevention, but actual treatment. And these can be helpful at decreasing the severity and decreasing risk of hospitalization. If you have COVID, if you know you've tested positive, or if you think you may, it's important to speak to your physician and ask if one of these treatments is right for you.